The Morning Drive returns with the Bagman and Pistol Pete.
If it were easy, we'd all do it, right, Mike?
That's right. At least I'd give it a shot anyway.
Would you?
Absolutely.
You would?
Why not? Ten minutes before the top of the hour, Kyle Petty on the way, James Small in 40 minutes. In the calendar right now. Hey, Pete?
Yes.
What is today?
Today, Bagman, is Thursday, February 9th, 2023.
Today is Cut the Cord Day.
Come here, bitch.
I don't want to do it.
Well, cut.
Tell you what, for some of those cord cutters out there, they're trying to find that black electrical tape to get her put back together again with some of these prices now and some of these financial analysis that are taking place.
Mm-hmm. As I saw someone tweet, I figured out a way what we should be calling cord cutting these days. Cable. Because it's the same thing.
Yeah.
It's the exact same thing. If you add up all the stuff, it's the same thing.
Yep. You had cable. And everybody's like, you know what? That's too much. Mm-hmm. Got to cut the cord. We're going to do away with that. We're going to get all this stuff. Well, now that you got all this other stuff, by putting it together and the associated price increases, there are some people I know that are paying more now than they were when they had cable, and they're going back to cable.
I know. Crazy. It's crazy. I have a little of both. I have a little of both. Got a little over here.
I don't want to do it.
Well, cut.
This Rocky trying to get his internet connection cut.
I can't see my service, Mick. You got to cut it.
By the way, he's draped in Eagles garb, too.
Well, I would think.
At the art museum.
Is he running up the stairs, or what's he doing?
Well, he's a statue, so it's kind of hard to bend those legs to get up there.
Have you seen any? Have there been reports of people chasing chickens around, trying to pick those up in preparation for this?
Well, no, they're chasing chickens around trying to get free eggs.
Well, that's a whole other story.
$9 a dozen of eggs. Are you kidding me? I mean, the shell. I'm eating a cardboard case.
Okay. All you got to do is buy a carton of those egg beaters, and it's the same thing. Everybody just settle down. It's not the economy. There's an avian flu out there that's killing birds. That's why it's so high. Okay?
I don't care what's causing it. All I know is when I need eggs, I'm paying $9 a dozen for them.
Well, okay. You know what? The yolk's on you.
Egg beaters. Come on.
Cheaper.
Today is National Pizza Day.
Pizza Hut is the appetite. What Jack Nicklaus is the golf.
Thank you, Bobby Knight. You throw a chair with a pizza on it when he was talking about that?
Yes. So you do something that I stumble across every now and then when I'm zipping up and down the dial. I've heard you do this a couple of times. You had pizza rankings on when you do Big Ten.
Yeah. We're going to be doing it today.
Explain that.
Well, we have, let's see, 8 games. So we'll go through the games today, John Crispin and I. And we'll tell you, like, if I don't have it in front of me, but like, let's say Indiana's playing Maryland. All right. This game has got the spice of a pepperoni pizza because of the flavor of what Indiana's been doing. And the Maryland Terrapins are trying to. And so we'll kind of give you the flavor of the game as a pizza. And then John will give us the. Well, first, John's funny because Crispin will give you, like, he'll go really deep. Like, well, Petey, I think this is a cracker crust pizza with imported provolone from the smallest Palermo. I know, he gets really into it. Robbie Hummel, another guy I work with, he just
cheese.
Goes, exactly right. Cheese.
Sausage.
Pepperoni. Gino's Pizza Roll. I'm not even watching that game. If I weren't doing the game, I wouldn't watch it. I mean, depends how you do it. But it's going to be fun today because today's National Pizza Day. Should I get pizza for dinner? Because I'm having pizza at the Super Bowl on Sunday. Is that too much pizza? What are they going to do?
Only you can. What will the tank allow?
The tank, yeah. You got to kind of watch that in ingestion as well. Yeah, all right.
Today is Read in the Bathtub Day.
I don't plan on reading anything
in
my own.
You're not in the bathtub.
So. Sit in my own filth and read something? What am I getting, being punished for something?
You and this sit in your filth.
Man, I only lay down in the shower. I love a good soak. You can't read while you're laying down the shower, so.
I love a good soak. I do.
Do you like the bath bombs, Baggy? Do you put those in?
I do. Bath bombs. Here's what I do because I've got my sciatic nerve kicks up from time to time. I'm one of those people that when I get up on an airplane, look at this. Where's he going? We're not getting off here for another 10 minutes. I don't know. I understand why these people got their chairs so fat. Okay.
Jeez.
My sciatic nerve sometimes, I can't feel my toes. That's how bad this is, especially if I sit in one spot for a long time. I always have to move.
Yeah.
So I had to get up, right? Well, mm-hmm. one of the things that helps with that mm-hmm. is I soak in Epsom salt. And it helps loosen that. I'm on the heating pad sometimes. It gets bad.
I might try that.
It goes right down my leg to my kneecap and sometimes to the tips of my toes in my right leg.
I will break my soaking in my own filth rule by maybe using a little Epsom salt and see if that helps my back issue.
You're just brining yourselves, essentially.
Like a big pickle. Like a big pickle.
You
for
would
the weekend.
Be amazed the healing effects of Epsom salt.
I'll try it. Now, the girls used to go. There was a store in the mall that sold those bombs. I forgot what it was called, those soap bombs. So one day, true story, they brought one home, didn't know what it was. It was sitting in the kitchen. It looked like it was a piece of cake or a candy or something. So I cut it. I said, what the hell is this?
Well, what are they healing in soap? Why are they leaving bath bombs in the kitchen?
I don't know. She was going to wrap it up for somebody.
Were they out of Tide Pods?
She was going to give it to somebody as a gift. And I was like, it looked beautiful. It was like this purple thing. I was like, oh, it looks like maybe I'll have a little steal of that. And I cut into it. I didn't bite into it. I cut into it, and it's like, what the hell kind of candy is this? And then, of course, I got yelled at.
Perhaps if you did bite into it, you would be suffering from the next celebration, which is toothache day. Listen, ain't nothing like toothache.
I hate it.
I mean, you get your teeth hurt, and everything hurts.
It's like, ugh. I know that's right.
It's like, what are we doing here? On this day in 1825.
Hey!
The U.S. House of Representatives elected John Quincy Adams president. No candidate had received a majority of electoral votes.
All right, get in there, JQA. You're the best we got.
On this day in 1870, the United States Weather Bureau was authorized by Congress. The Bureau is officially known today as the National Weather Service.
Yes, the NWS on their Twitter feed. Yeah.
Right.
That is correct.
Thank you.
On this day in 1884, Thomas Edison and Patrick Kenny executed a patent application for a chemical recording stock quotation telegraph.
Wow. A lot of big words for what?
It's a lot going on there.
It's a lot going on there.
I have no idea, but it was U.S. patent 314,115.
Plus 1,000.
On this day in 1895, volleyball was invented by W.G. Morgan.
I've become a big volleyball fan watching college volleyball. I think it's a really good game. It's a really fast-paced game. It's over like in 2 hours. It's perfect.
I used to play volleyball in school. I love volleyball.
Really? Mm-hmm. Were you a setter or a digger?
All of it. I could serve back up. Here comes Baggy. Get in there, son. Boom!
Get it.
On this day in 1895. The first college basketball game was played as Minnesota State School of Agriculture defeated the Porkers of Hamline College 9-3.
You open your mouth, my fist goes south.
Clearly, it was a defensive affair that night.
Yeah, I had the Porkers plus 7, so I actually won that game.
On this day in 1932, America entered the two-man bobsled competition for the first time at the Winter Olympic Games held at Lake Placid, New York.
Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride.
Ah, yes.
I love that movie.
Cool Runnings. That's a good one. Yep.
On this day in 1960, the first star was placed on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. You're a shining star, no matter who you are. Petey, take a guess of who got the first one.
What year was it?
1960.
1960? It went to Clark Gable.
Joanne Woodward.
Really? Okay. I like her. That's good.
Birthdays today. Carol King is 81. She composed the music for that gem right there. Michael B. Jordan, 36 today. Tom Hiddleston, 42. Saquon Barkley, 26. Joe Pesci, 80. William Henry Harrison would have been 250. And, of course, in the world of NASCAR, birthdays today for Brennan Newberry, Kevin Buckler, and our friend Todd Parent.
Happy birthday, one and all, on this Thursday, February 9, 2023.